everybody, welcome back to another My Damn Toys video. Today I have my full WrestleMania 35 predictions for you guys. As you guys know, we're going to run through the entire card. I'm going to give you my thoughts on the feud, on the matches, on everything in between, give you my full rundown of everything, how I think it's going to go, how I think it should go, every single thing regarding WrestleMania 35 and its match card. To be honest with you guys, it's going to be a long show. You know, it's probably going to be 7 or 8 hours. I think it's about 15 to 18 matches are predicted to be on this show. I think I have the full card fleshed out here for you guys. I'm going to lay out all the matches, go through every single one of them, and let you guys know what I exactly think. To be WrestleMania, I'm not as hyped for this show as I think I should be. There are some matches that I'm definitely looking forward to, but there are a lot of matches on this card that I think could have been altered in some different way and made a lot more special or a lot better for WrestleMania. But you know, we are given what we're given. I'm going to go in with guns blazing. I'm going to give you my best thoughts, everything on it, guys. So let's go ahead and get started. Before we get into the kickoff show, guys, I do want to make note of something. I know that Elias is supposed to be the musical leader or whatever of WrestleMania 35, and then, of course, Alexa Bliss is your host for WrestleMania 35, but Undertaker, John Cena, and my boy Kevin Owens are not advertised for any matchups. Are they going to be intertwined with something with Elias? That's what I would figure. You know, if Undertaker, my boy John Cena, and Kevin don't show up, then I guess they would be thrusted into something with Elias or Alexa Bliss throughout the show. Given that Kevin Owens has been, you know, doing his KO show on SmackDown Live the past couple weeks, I think that, you know, he could easily interfere with Alexa Bliss or do something of that nature with Alexa Bliss, mixing him with Elias, possibly The Rock, John Cena, or Undertaker showing up, and I think that is something that will happen. But I do hate that my boys John Cena and Kevin Owens will not be wrestling on this show, or at least it doesn't look that way. But starting things off with the kickoff show, guys, we have the first matchup of many, and it is the 6th annual Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal. Of course, Colin Jost and Michael Chi, or She, or He, or T of SNL will be present in this thing. You know, they've been going on with Braun Strowman in a terrible storyline that I do not give a flying crap about. I really do not care. It's just amazing to see how far Braun Strowman has fallen off, guys. I could not give a crap. Like, it's just sickening. But anyways, guys, some of the confirmed interest for this is Andrade, Cien Almas, Apollo, Titus O'Neil, Tyler Breeze, Jinder Mahal, Noe Jose, Bobby Roode, Chad Gable, Kalisto, Grand Metalik, Lince Dorado, Bo Dallas, Curtis Axel, Heath Slater, Rhino, Victor Connor, Ali, Mustafa Ali, Shelton Benjamin, Luke Gallows, Carl Anderson, Matt and Jeff Hardy, Otis Tucker, and EC3. And there's a lot of things that I have to say about this matchup because honestly, guys, this matchup does not matter. This is for everybody that does not have a matchup on WrestleMania's card. I think that this is just a throwaway. I wish that they would do something with this battle royal, make it mean something, throw in a title opportunity or something like that. I think the easiest answer to say with this would be Braun Strowman. I'm going to predict Braun Strowman. I think I've predicted Braun Strowman every single time he's been in this thing and he always loses, but I think this is going to be the year that he finally captures the trophy that means absolutely nothing. But a couple things I wanted to add here. Why aren't the Hardy Boys taking on the Usos 2-on-2 for the SmackDown Live Tag Titles? And why is it Cien Almas, Mustafa Ali? Why aren't those guys added to the U.S. title match? Why couldn't you make like a big 6 or 8 man ladder match for the United States Championship? We'll get into this a little bit later in the video, but I just wanted to throw that in there. But I'm going with Braun Strowman to win this Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal. Flipping it over to the female side, guys, the second pre-show matchup, we have the 2nd annual WrestleMania Women's Battle Royal featuring Asuka, Carmella, Naomi, Lana, Mandy Rose, Sonya Deville, Nikki Cross, Dana Brooke, Ruby Riott, Liv Morgan, Sarah Logan, Mickie James, Zelina Vega, and more. Honestly, there's only one way this thing should go, and that should be Asuka kicking the hell out of everybody and throwing them over the top rope. SmackDown Live ended with that big 18-man mixed tag team matchup that was absolutely terrible. It ended the right way with Asuka turning, you know, that she hugged Jeff Hardy, you know, eliminating everybody, and then she tossed out Jeff Hardy. I think that's the way this thing should go at WrestleMania. Asuka should definitely win here, and there shouldn't be any buts about it. You know, the way she got her championship taken from her by Charlotte, and now it is the only right thing to do. Even though this Battle Royal means absolutely nothing, I think the best thing for her would be to just dominate this matchup, throw every woman out, and claim her dominance in this thing, and Asuka winning. That's the only way it should go, and if that doesn't happen, then I hope Ruby Riott wins it. But I'm going with Asuka to dominate here. Go Asuka. Kicking off the main show, guys, we have the Cruiserweight Championship match between Buddy Murphy and Tony Nese. Tony Nese did defeat my boy Cedric Alexander to earn this opportunity. I thought for sure that Cedric was going to get it, but they did go with Tony Nese, which is a fresh matchup here, but I don't think that anybody is on Buddy Murphy's level. I think that Buddy Murphy will retain here. Hopefully, these guys tear it down. I know Tony Nese can move. Buddy Murphy can obviously move. He's proved it over and over again why he is the best in the Cruiserweight division. I'm going with Buddy Murphy in a solid matchup. Even though this is an awesome opportunity, opportunity for Tony Nese. I just don't see anybody dethroning Buddy Murphy at this point. Next up, guys, we have the Raw Tag Team Championship match between The Revival taking on fellow figure collectors, the Major Brothers, or Curt Hawkins and Zack Ryder. I think that Zack Ryder and Curt Hawkins are, you know, pleading for WWE on Twitter or something. I think that this match is official. If it's not at the time of recording, I think that this matchup will take place. You know, Zack Ryder and Curt Hawkins aren't advertised for the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal. So I think this matchup is going to take place, and I think that the Major Brothers, Zack Ryder and Curt Hawkins, are going to take the Raw Tag Team Championships from the Revival, and that is what's going to happen. I think they're going to end Curt Hawkins' 265 or 267 or 200, whatever the crap it is now. It's up in the upwards 200s. They're going to end that losing streak here at WrestleMania 35, have a nice little crowning moment for him and Zack Ryder here, and they're going to capture the Raw Tag Team Championships. Of course, if this match isn't taking place, then you can just ignore it, but I think they are going to add this matchup to the WrestleMania 35 card. Next up, we have the Fatal 4-Way for the WWE Women's Tag Team Championships between the champions Sasha Banks and Bayley defending their titles versus the Iconics versus Beth Phoenix and Natalya versus Tamina Snuka and Nia Jax. And to be honest with you guys, I thought they could have done this matchup a whole lot better. I wish they would have done the Tag Team Champions versus a team from Raw versus a team from SmackDown versus a team from NXT. I thought that would have been a lot better here. The random tag team thrown together of Beth Phoenix and Natalya is just super random to me. Nia Jax and Tamina Snuka have had like a million title opportunities. Why the crap are they getting so many title opportunities? They're two of the worst wrestlers in the entire world, and they keep getting all these opportunities, and they're just terrible stuff, man. And then the Iconics, I just, man, whatever. I think that Sasha Banks and Bayley should win this matchup. I don't think they will. I think they're going to give the titles to the Iconics. I think they're honestly going to do that. Peyton Royce and Billie Kay, I think they're honestly going to put those titles on them. Even though I want Bayley and Sasha to win, I'm going to predict that the Iconics win here in this matchup. I don't support that idea. I don't want that to happen, but I think it's going to happen, guys. The Iconics are going to go home with the Women's Tag Team Championships following WrestleMania 35. Next up, we have the last of our tag team efforts at WrestleMania 35. It is the Fatal 4-Way for the SmackDown Live Tag Team Championships between the champions, the Usos, defending their titles against Ricochet and Aleister Black, Sheamus and Cesaro, aka The Bar, and then finally Rusev and Shinsuke Nakamura, which is something I want to bring up to you guys. First of all, why is Aleister Black and Ricochet challenging for the SmackDown Live Tag titles at WrestleMania when they were just over on Raw on literally Monday night challenging the Revival for the Raw Tag Team Championships? And then another thing I want to say is, why is Rusev and Shinsuke Nakamura even a tag team? They would be much better off taking Shinsuke Nakamura and Rusev, Mustafa Ali and CN Almas, take R-Truth as well, plug them into the Rey Mysterio versus Samoa Joe matchup, and you have a big United States Championship ladder match at WrestleMania. That would be a lot better. You would remove all these multi-man Fatal 4-Way Tag Team Championship efforts. You could take Ricochet and Aleister Black off the card. They don't have to be on WrestleMania. I think they lift the card up. However, since they are going to be in a match on Friday night at NXT TakeOver, I think you could take them out. You could take The Bar out, put them in the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal, and bring the Hardys out of the Memorial Battle Royal, and then challenge the Usos in a two-on-two tag team championship match. That's the way I would book WrestleMania if it was my power. I think that would be a lot more better. You'd have the U.S. ladder match. You would give Aleister and Ricochet a little break. You'd have The Bar replace the Hardys, and the Hardys replace The Bar, and you would have such a great effort there, man. But I'm not going to lie to you. The eight-man tag these guys had on SmackDown Live this past Tuesday last night was absolutely fantastic. I thought the flow of the match was good. You had everybody getting their spots in, and I think that if this matchup here at WrestleMania goes anything like that, which I'm sure it will, all eight of these guys can work. I think it's going to be a great matchup at Mania, and it could possibly be the best tag team match that we see at the entire show. So I think that the Usos are going to retain here. I don't see them dropping the titles right now. I think that they're going to move on to another pay-per-view and finally take on the Hardy Boys, most likely, and possibly lose there or something. But I don't see them losing here at Mania. I'm going with the Usos to retain. Next up is the Battle of the Besties. We got the best in the world, Shane McMahon, taking on The Miz in a Falls Count Anywhere matchup. I think that this matchup is going to be underrated, to be honest with you guys. I really am not looking forward to this match, but I'm kind of looking forward to where they take it creatively. Like, what are we going to see from Shane McMahon? What big spot are we going to get? Because you know that is the only reason this matchup and whole storyline was booked in the first place. I don't think that, you know, there's not really any big stakes at this matchup. You know, it's just a feud over a dad. It's kind of just a weird thing going on. We have a heel Shane McMahon taking on a babyface Miz. It's really weird. But anyways, I think that the Miz is going to win. I think that maybe Shane jumps off of something big and he misses, and then Miz gets the pinfall or something like that. I do think that the Miz is going to win, even though he was looking hella strong. You know, he defeated, in a 3-on-1 false count anywhere match on SmackDown Live, he defeated Sanity. You know, it's not really saying much these days on the main roster, but he did win a 3-on-1 matchup going into WrestleMania, which typically means he's going to lose here, but I think he's going to pull it off. Maybe his dad helps him win or something, but I do think that the Miz will win in a nice little... I think, I'm telling you, man, it's going to be underrated. Shane McMahon always puts on a show, so don't be surprised if this match kind of, you know, stands out from the rest. Next up, we have my least favorite wrestler, Trash Corbin, going up with one of my favorite wrestlers of all time, Kurt Angle, and Kurt Angle's farewell match. And this one, you know, everybody's crapping on it, guys. Everybody wants to jump on the bandwagon now and crap on Trash Corbin. I've been crapping on him since NXT. I cannot stand the man. I literally don't think he has a single talented bone in his body. He puts on solid matchups when given with the right talent, and he has a cool entrance theme, and he has a cool finishing move. But besides that, I don't really see what's going on, man. I don't like this matchup at all. I would have loved to see John Cena, but to be honest with you guys, Kurt Angle literally cannot go anymore. I don't know what it is. He's in pretty good shape. Like, I don't think he's out of shape. He literally looks good. He works out all the time. But as far as keeping up in the ring, running between the ropes, keeping up like Triple H does, like other older dudes do, he just can't go at this point in his life. I don't know what it is. I think he deals with quad and knee injuries all the time, you know, from given his background and everything he's been through. I just don't think he can move around very well. We saw it in all the matchups leading up to this point, and it's very sad to see. You know, I wanted to see him get a great match out of somebody in his last ride at WrestleMania. I just don't see it happening. I think that maybe John Cena comes out and helps him win or something like that, and he ends it with John Cena, or possibly having John Cena get involved in this matchup. But I do think that Kurt Angle is going to win here. Kurt Angle needs to win here. I know that usually when wrestlers are retiring, they usually go out on their back putting somebody over. But in this case, it doesn't matter. It's Trash Corbin. He needs to beat Trash Corbin, lay him out, and have Kurt Angle go out on top here with a dub. And I'm predicting that Kurt Angle will win. Even though it's not the matchup we want, I think that Kurt Angle will win. Next up, guys, we have another one-on-one. We got the big dog Roman Reigns taking on Drew McIntyre, and I think this match is another sleeper. I think that this one's going to have, you know, the makings of a good matchup. I can't wait to see how these guys go. Hopefully that it's a hard-hitting car crash. Given both dudes are big, both dudes are strong, I hope we see the athleticism of Drew McIntyre on display in this matchup. It's pretty obvious how this one's going to go. The big dog is not going to lose here. Back from this sickness and this illness, man, he's going to come back on fire. He's going to win, and it's going to go down that way. Roman Reigns is going to win this matchup, but I just hope that Drew McIntyre looks good in defeat. Make him look strong. Maybe it takes two or three spears. Maybe it takes, you know, a few more Superman punches. Make Drew McIntyre look good in defeat here, because I know he's not going to win, but the big dog will win here. I'm predicting it. Hopefully Drew McIntyre looks good in the end. Next up, we have the United States Championship match between Samoa Joseph taking on Rey Mysterio. Rey Mysterio did undergo an ankle injury on Monday Night Raw, and he had to sit out of SmackDown Live. I don't think it's too serious at this point. I think they're going to monitor it all the way up till Sunday night at WrestleMania 35, but I think he is going to be able to go. If he's not able to go, it's going to be interesting to see if they go with my ladder match idea. Maybe they pull a bunch of guys into this thing and have like a big old match, but I don't see that happening. I think we are going to get the one-on-one here. I think that Samoa Joe, I think it's very important that he wins here. You know, leading up to this matchup, they made him lose and lose and lose. He lost to Kofi Kingston in the gauntlet match. He lost to Rey Mysterio in a tag team effort, and then he lost to Kurt Angle on Monday Night Raw. I think it is imperative that this man wins. Rey Mysterio lost to Trash Corbin on a deep six, no less. So both of these men are coming in pretty depleted and with zero momentum whatsoever, but I think that Samoa Joe does need to win here. I know he picked up a win over Mustafa Ali on SmackDown Live. However, he needs to win here, retain the championship, and maybe we'll get some other things going on with Joe following WrestleMania. But I'm going to go with Samoa Joseph to retain his U.S. title. Next is the Intercontinental Championship match between my boy, the Demon Finn Balor, taking on Bobby Trashley. And to be honest, guys, I did not want this matchup. I did not want Bobby Trashley carrying the Intercontinental Championship into WrestleMania. I thought that a lot better idea would have been to have Finn Balor hold on to the championship, have Bobby Lashley go into the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal, have a better challenger for Finn Balor going into Mania, and have the Demon come out at Mania and put on a great performance to open the show. But that is not what they did. did. They had him lose to Bobby Trashley on Monday Night Raw, leading to this matchup. We are getting the Demon, thank God. Even though this really makes no sense in the form of storyline, because why would Finn Balor summon the Demon to take on Bobby Trashley, but he wouldn't summon the Demon to take on Brock Lesnar to try and capture the Universal Championship at the Royal Rumble? That really doesn't make sense to me. I think that it would have been a lot better if the Demon showed up, but I guess they wanted to keep the Demon undefeated, which is why he's going to win here. I think there's no other way it should go. Finn Balor will walk out of Brooklyn, New York with that Intercontinental Championship, and there's no buts about it. I think he's going to win, and it's going to be great. It's going to be great to see my boy Finn Balor with that Intercontinental Championship again. Two-time Intercontinental Champion. The Demon will look good. Can't wait to see what the Demon looks like here, and it should be fantastic. It should be a burial. It should be a burial. It should be a squeakity squash match. Shouldn't be much of anything, and Finn Balor should walk out with the IC title. Next up, we have one of the matches that I am the most looking forward to. We got my boy Randall Keith taking on AJ Styles, the phenomenal one. I cannot wait for this one, guys. The build has been fantastic. Both of these men ripping into each other. Obviously, AJ Styles representing all of the independent talents, all the indie, you know, vanilla midgets, as they like to call them, and Randy Orton's representing the machine or the WWE product and everything like that. I think that this is going to be a great clash. I think I have this one as the low-key match of the night. I think that this is going to be great. Guys are going to tell a great story. We did see a phenomenal forearm reversed into an RKO, which did surprise me on SmackDown Live, which means we're not going to see that matchup in this match. Hopefully we get a 450 splash, though. Springboard 450, AJ Styles coming off the top rope, and bam, into an RKO to finish the matchup. That's what I would like to see here, but I'm going to go with Randy Orton. I think that Randy Orton's going to win here. Maybe later on we get a babyface WWE champion, and that is going to be the next feud that we see going on into the summer, is a top heel Randy Orton coming off a win versus AJ. He's going to be the next contender in line for that WWE Championship. So it's going to start here at Mania, and Randy Orton will defeat AJ Styles in a great matchup. Next up, we have the no-holds-barred Triple H career on the line. Triple H taking on Batista, two of my favorites of all time. Batista taking on Hunter Hearst Helmsley. You guys know this thing is going to be 20 to 25 minutes long. I think it's going to be a slow burn. Every single WrestleMania Triple H matchup always goes pretty much the same way. It's going to be a slow burn. Guys beating the hell out of each other. Some announce table spots on the outside. Even though it is no-holds-barred, though, it may get a little chippy here and there. We may see some weapons involved. Sledgehammer, chair, all that good jazz. I think this matchup has the potential. You know, both guys have rocked it, but I think Triple H will come out on top, man. I don't think he's going to retire here. I don't think this is his retirement match. He will slay Dave Batista. The Animal is going to go down here at Mania. Batista is going to do the job for Paul. After Triple H, you know, put Batista over at WrestleMania 21, I think it is time for Batista to do the same thing for Triple H here at WrestleMania 35. And I'm going to go with Triple H winning this thing in a nice slow burn matchup. I'm super hyped for Batista's return, man. One of my favorites ever, and Triple H, obviously one of my favorites ever as well. So I'm definitely looking forward to this matchup, and it is definitely one of those. This didn't have the best build, you know, going forward. I thought this was going to have a lot better build than we got from these two guys, but it was still intense, and I think that we're going to get a great matchup out of them here at Mania, and hopefully that's true. But I'm going with Triple H to win. Next, we have the WWE Championship match between Daniel Bryan along with Eric Rowan taking on Kofi Mania. Kofi Kingston and his New Day brothers will be at ringside, Xavier Woods and Big E. Obviously, everybody wants Kofi Kingston to win here, and I think they are going to pull the trigger, guys. I think they're going to give the WWE Championship to Kofi. This buildup has been pretty good. I'm not as, like, big into it as everyone else. I am a fan of Kofi. I've always loved Kofi, but I haven't been. I'm not like everyone else where I'm just, like, you know, absurdly just freaking obsessed with the idea of him winning the WWE Championship. I'm just, you know, I'm there. It's cool if he wins it. It's cool if he doesn't. I think it's cool if, you know, he rolls in there and doesn't win it, but I think it would be a great moment for him to win it. So I'm on either side. It doesn't really matter, but I think they are going to give it to him here. Kofi Kingston, after all he's overcome, I do think they've overdone it, you know, with the gauntlet matches and the constant just getting in the way and all that. I thought that, you know, they've definitely overdone it as far as that is concerned, but it is an intense storyline that fell into their laps, and I'm glad they're going along with it since, you know, the WWE Universe and captured it. They really want it. I think it's going to be a cool moment to crown Kofi here at Mania, and he will finally dethrone Daniel Bryan. However, there is a however. After this, I think that Randy Orton will be the number one contender, and Randy Orton will take the strap from Kofi in the next month or two. I don't expect a long run at all. I think it's going to be maybe a 3-week, 4-week thing, and Randy Orton will become your WWE champion next after Kofi Kingston. Next, we have the Universal Championship match between the Beast Incarnate, Brock Lesnar, taking on my boy, Seth Rollins. And to be honest, guys, Seth Rollins is not winning this match, man. I'm going to go ahead and tell you, I'm going with Brock Lesnar to retain. I know it sucks. I don't want it. I want the Universal Championship on Monday Night Raw every week. I want my man, Seth Rollins, to hold that Universal title. I think it would look great on his waist. I think it would be a beautiful plaque to get and hang on my wall, dethroning the Beast, ending this reign of terror at WrestleMania 35, but I just don't see it happening, man. They're not going to give us, you know, Kofi, Becky, and Seth Rollins all winning it, and you just have to sit back and you have to realize that we're not going to get 8 fairy tales in one night. It's not going to be Curt Hawkins, Rey Mysterio, you know, Aleister Black, and Ricochet. It's not going to be everybody winning their title matches. It's just not, that doesn't make, you know, storyline. You got to have some heels retain, and I think they're going to do it here, man. If it were me booking it, I would totally have Seth, Kofi, and Becky winning, but I just don't think we're going to live in a fantasy land here at WrestleMania 35. So I'm going to go with Brock retaining, but I am very interested in this matchup. I'm very hyped to see how they book it. I think that Brock always works so well. Every match he's had, you know, with AJ, Daniel Bryan, Finn Balor, smaller guys like that, he always rocks the house. The matchup that Brock Lesnar, Seth, and John Cena had was great. Of course, you don't have John Cena in the matchup, but I still think with Seth, he can do some great work, and I can't wait to see, you know, how they book this matchup, how it goes about. But I would love to see Seth Rollins win, but I'm going to pick for my predictions Brock Lesnar retaining the Universal Championship. And mercifully, we are at the main event, guys. The first ever women's main event of WrestleMania. My girl Becky Lynch taking on Ronda Rousey and Charlotte Flair in a triple threat match, winner take all for the Raw and SmackDown Live Women's Championship titles. Now, I gotta say, this if we're talking about storylines that have been overbooked, this is definitely one that has been overbooked. Since October, we knew that this matchup was going to be building. We knew that we were going to get to this matchup eventually. But all of the obstacles and the fire hoops and the daggum ramps and just everything we had to get through to get to this point, man. I am so ready for this matchup, and I'm ready for this little debacle and storyline to come to a conclusion, because my God, man, we had like several suspensions, several arrests, we had injury angles and Royal Rumbles and interferences and this and that, and this person attacks this person, but if this happens, then this happens, but this, and then we had the other title added, and then we had this title this, and it's just absolutely nuts to think of all of the road that we have went down to get to this matchup. But with that being said, hope to God, with all of that being said, Becky Lynch walks out of WrestleMania 35 with both the Raw and SmackDown Live Women's Championships on her shoulders, ending WrestleMania with the fireworks and everything, holding both titles high, the crowd going nuts, and hopefully that's the way this goes. I heard there's a rumor going around that, you know, something big, a huge swerve is coming for the ending of WrestleMania 35. That's just, you know, something that I heard. However, you never know. I mean, we hear crap all the time. We hear different rumors, and we hear different storylines and all that crap going around every single year around WrestleMania time, so you have to take everything with a grain of salt. But I'm looking forward to this match. Hopefully these women deliver, and you know, they live up to the hype, and they deliver on what they can do. I know that they can do it. They've delivered. Every single woman in this matchup has delivered every single time they step a foot in the ring, and I'm excited for it, and I can't wait, and I think that Becky Lynch is going to win here, hopefully, and I'm going to predict Becky Lynch to win. You know, I had Kofi winning, I had Becky winning, and I have Brock winning. That's pretty fair there. You got 2 out of the 3. It's not all 3, but it's, you know, it's good enough. But with that being said, that is my full WrestleMania 35 predictions, guys. If you guys made it all the way through, you guys are actual champions. I love you so much. If you stayed all the way to the end, comment down below, My Damn Mania, and I will really appreciate that. You guys are so awesome if you stayed to the very end. I would love to know your thoughts down below on my predictions as well as your own predictions. Comment if you can remember all the matches, be sure to comment down below all of your favorites, which match for you're looking the most forward to, as well as who you think is going to win. Thank you guys so very much for watching. Subscribe to the channel for more epic WWE figure videos. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys. I will be live tweeting during WrestleMania, and I will be probably adding stuff to my Instagram story, guys. So if you have a Twitter or an Instagram, definitely go give me a follow at MyDamnToys as you see it. And that is all. Thank you guys so much, and I will see you in the next video.